The human body, a miracle of nature. Muscles, bones, and tendons interact, enabling all kinds of different movements. This requires functioning arms and legs, whatever they happen to look like. At the age of 17, Hugh Hare dreamed of being a mountain climber.
I love climbing, it's absolutely wonderful. And it's led me to where I am today.
Now he has reached the top, but with his inventions, high-tech prostheses.
Technologically speaking, my climbing legs are fairly simple compared to the legs I use for walking.
The prostheses he uses in everyday life are no ordinary walking aids. They are his own inventions. They may be artificial, but they really are legs. Quick and agile. Hugh Hare is a professor at the renowned Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, and one of the pioneers in the field of bionics, a mixture of biology and technology. The aim of his development, prostheses should not be foreign bodies, but fit the limbs really comfortably. And the movement of artificial legs and feet should imitate, and thus replace, natural walking. It was a stroke of fate that gave his life its decisive turn. From the age of 7, he scaled rock faces and soon became a member of the climbing elite. But when he was 17, he suffered very serious frostbite up in the mountains, and the doctors had to amputate both his legs below the knee. His dream seemed to have been shattered. But the young athlete didn't give up. He designed his very own climbing prosthesis. Beforehand, he had only been interested in climbing and very little in his schoolwork. But the amputation marked the turning point.
After I experienced this process of designing the artificial part of my body, that experience was so inspiring that I realized, gosh, if I deeply understood mathematics and science and engineering, who knows what I would be able to create.
And what he creates are unique prostheses, brilliant combinations of mechanics, electronics, medical expertise, and biological processes. There are approximately 3 to 4 million people with seriously debilitating amputations across the world each year.
Each bionic limb has 3 computers, the brains of the system, various sensors to sense its environment, and a muscle tendon-like actuator, a motor system. And when I walk, it adapts automatically with variations in speed and terrain in a way that's completely natural. We actually embedded on chip the fundamentals of how muscles are controlled that span the ankle joint.
To do that, he and his team first had to go back to basics and with great precision explore the physiology of walking. Where are the swing phases of the leg? What is the rolling motion of the foot? What modulations occur during standing, running, and walking? Since the year 2000, when they founded the Center for Extreme Bionics, Hugh Hare and his team have calculated algorithms from these walking experiments, creating technical analogies to the biological ones. This information is contained inside mini processors in the artificial ankle. They control the processes. What's special here is that the intelligent mini processors react instantly without any delay to things like foot position, speed, or power transmission. In this way, they sense and control the way their wearer walks.
This is the first prosthesis in history that's powered, that emulates lost muscle function. Conventional prostheses are passive, like a bicycle's passive, so only the residual muscles power the movement. But with this, it actually injects energy into the walking or running gait, emulating lost muscle function.
But Hugh Hare not only wants to understand the dynamic processes of walking and realize them technically in the prosthesis, he also wants to make the material smarter and adapt it. This device measures the firmness of muscles and tissues in the leg. On the computer, bones and soft tissues of the stump are modeled, along with their texture and surface. The aim is for the prosthetic shaft to adapt to the interface as naturally as possible. Man and technology, leg and prosthesis, compensate for each other. Wherever the muscle is soft, the prosthesis is equipped with hard material, and at the hard locations, it becomes softer. To apply the method individually and quasi-orthopedically in the future, the biomechatronics engineers at MIT are now experimenting with a handy scanner like this one. Many patients clearly remember the moment they switched from passive to bionic prostheses.
Within minutes, often, a person can walk normally and says to us, "I have my body back, I have my life back."
Oh my God.
Are they pushing you up?
Yes, I can't even describe it.
In addition to the ankle prosthesis, Hugh Hare has also invented another very special prosthesis.
My research group at MIT has developed a number of innovations. One is an artificial knee. So basically, this is used for someone that's amputated above the knee and serves as the artificial knee joint. As a person walks, it has its own intelligence. It adapts automatically to different in speeds and terrains, and then modulates the resistance about the knee joint. So a person can walk with normal biomechanics and safely to reduce the threat of falling, for example.
The professor and his team at MIT are already thinking ahead. Prostheses that are screwed directly to the bone. And sensors directly connected to the nerves in the leg stump, passing on commands to the prosthesis. At MIT, these experiments are already underway. There are so-called exoskeletons, like this exo-boot in its testing phase. In a few years' time, these could help people without walking difficulties to walk or run faster. Hugh Hare is successfully overcoming disabilities with the aid of bionics for physical well-being and greater quality of life.
To me, I am utterly fascinated by bionics. It's human enhancement. So I just love designing bionics. I love every few months upgrading my own legs so I have better balance, I can move faster. You know, it's interesting because my biological body, as I age, gets worse and worse due to age-related degeneration, but the artificial part of my body gets better in time. So I predict when I'm 80 years old, my balance will be better than an 18-year-old. So that's a lot of fun.